What is FDL? It is a wild ride.
The Frontier Development Lab is an AI program that brings researchers together to tackle some of the biggest challenges humanity faces.
When we think about space exploration, we often focus on the technology required to travel to distant moons and distant planets. But various doses of cosmic radiation can increase the incidence of lifetime development of cancer. Can we build a machine learning framework that can identify the biological factors, genetics, that make one astronaut more susceptible to space radiation-induced cancer?
Honestly, a lot of us thought at the beginning that may not be possible.
If you can identify the causes, you can identify the holy grail, which is preventative mechanisms.
We were thinking about that in terms of how we translate that into space, but of course, there's a huge impact of cancer on everyone on Earth.
Intel's federated learning has the potential to be used for cancer, but also for a lot of other diseases that are out there.
I am Dr. John Calantari. I'm an assistant professor at the Mayo Clinic. I try to develop AI models and AI systems that tackle the greatest challenges in medicine and healthcare. The primary challenge in healthcare and medicine is understanding the causes of a disease. There are decades and decades of data on our patients that we record in our patient records. How do we mine that trove of data to understand what genes are causal for cancer progression?
Machine learning has radically changed how we do lots of tasks. However, it has some big limitations when it comes to healthcare and the biosciences.
The challenges across biosciences are always the same. You have very small amounts of data for very complex things.
And to overcome that, we need to amass data from across different populations so that we can fill in the gaps. And this is possible if you look beyond the walls of a single institution.
The challenge is accessing healthcare data.
Data, especially in healthcare settings, can't be sent outside because of restrictions such as HIPAA.
If the data is hard to get to, is there a way to bring the AI model to that data? The group came together and realized the most efficient solution is implementing Intel's federated learning framework.
What federated learning does is it flips the conventional way of doing deep learning training, which is to bring all of your data to a central place. And instead, the data doesn't need to be sent. It's just the model, which happens to be quite a bit smaller. The models get sent back and averaged or combined in some way to actually preserve a lot of the information without needing to violate any of the regulatory restrictions around it. With federated learning, it's possible to actually get access to data that normally wouldn't be available.
Now that the team can receive the data, the next problem, getting a bigger data set.
There's only so many astronauts that have been to space to actually study these causal effects of cosmic radiation on their DNA.
106, to be exact.
How do you make a model based on a very small sample size?
To solve this challenge, the team came up with a novel approach.
Hey, Paul.
Hi, John. So we have human astronaut data. We have a collection of mouse data as well. So the idea there was, can we combine human data with mouse model data in order to train these algorithms using the OpenFL framework?
If I understand you correctly, you guys are basically using rodent data as a homolog for human radiation data.
Yeah, precisely.
The team built up a big enough data set to effectively train a viable AI model that can predict which genes cause cancer in astronauts.
Sounds like magic.
Yes, in some ways it is.
This is an approach that can be applied to everyone on Earth.
I think we're really on the verge of AI making some really transformative steps forward.
With Intel's federated learning, AI can mine that trove of data that we've been collecting in healthcare for the past century and begin to build a more comprehensive model of disease. Pursuing challenges in healthcare, life sciences, space biology using AI is possible and should be focused on tackling blue sky. It's upon us to find those problems that seem impossible because those have the greatest potential to make an impact in ways that we can't imagine.